All right. Today also we are writing a memo and learning how to write a memo. You've already understood what is a memo. So memos are short notices, short messages, which is important. जो कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के इनसाइड होता है. इट इज एन इनसाइड मैसेज इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एंड मेमो इज द मोस्ट यूज्ड रिटन डॉक्यूमेंटेशन इन एनी काइंड ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. कैन यू सी द स्लाइड? कैन यू सी द स्लाइड?
Yes, ma'am.
Writing a memo, business communication and report writing. So we are talking about writing a memorandum. Today you will know the definition of memo, introduction of memo, advantages of memo, purpose of memo, and characteristics of memo. Write down the questions. Define what is a memo. Define what is a memo.
मैम सीआर अमन लिख के लाया मैम. सीआर अमन लिख के लाया है
क्या?
मेमोरेंडम का एडवांटेज.
ठीक है, फाइन. व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ अ मेमो? व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ अ मेमो? क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ मेमो. सेकंड advantages of a memo. Third, what is the purpose of writing a memo? Why do we write a memo? The purpose of writing a memo. What are the characteristics of a memo? What are the parts of a memo? So memo is something as a reminder, to remind someone, to call to action, to recall, to record an event. Why it is served? For giving some information, can be proceedings, can be policies, can be a new product, new policy, new rules and regulations. Anything which is important in the organization can be shared in a memo. Memos can be written either downwards, it means from the top hierarchy to the persons working in the lower hierarchy, which is downward and vertical, up top to bottom, and horizontal, it means persons working in the same hierarchy. So what is the communication flow of a memo? Either it is vertical, ya fir it is horizontal. Did you understand vertical and horizontal? Communication flow downward hota hai. Upward kabhi nahi hota. Person working in the lower hierarchy cannot give a memo to the person working in the higher hierarchy. Memos can also be given for praising somebody. Memos can be given for issues regarding discipline, some concern. Supposing a person is continuously coming late, if a person is taking too much of leave, if a person is coming but not doing his work properly. So these are the situations where the higher authority can issue a memo to you. Yes. It can also be given to praise somebody. You've done a wonderful job, so you might get a praise. You might get incentives. So either it can be given to convey some good news or can be given to convey bad news. Right? Memos can be given individually and memos can also be given in a group. All this I already discussed, isn't it? Let us move ahead. Definition. A memorandum is considered inside correspondence. Please take down the notes, whatever you see on the slide. The definition already is there. When I say it is an inside communication or correspondence, it means it is written within the organization. You cannot write a memo to anybody outside the organization. Jab bhi aap likhenge, to it is within the organization. So a memorandum is considered inside correspondence. It means to anybody in your company, to anybody who is working in your company. You cannot give a memo to somebody working in XYZ company. A memo is a written statement. Memos can never be done orally. Like somebody said, okay, do this. In any business organization, you already have made a presentation. The importance and advantages of written communication, because it carries proof that somebody issued a memo. So a written statement you prepare especially for a person or communicate an order to give them information about a particular method. तो या आप information देते हैं या आप order करते हैं या किसी को आप praise कर रहे हैं या किसी को आप warning दे रहे हैं. To praise someone, to give warning, to give instructions, to share some policies, changes. So now, what is your definition? What is a memo? You know, what I want you to do, write down the definition. Even look at the dictionary meaning, what is a memo? Research kar lijiye, aur bhi dekh lijiye. Aur sab mila karke phir apna ek definition banaiye, which will be unique. I don't want you to mug up anything. Jo bhi aap likhoge, याद करके या रट करके मगअप करके नहीं लिखना है. यू कैन रिसर्च व्हाट इज मेमो, सी लॉट ऑफ सी द डिक्शनरी मीनिंग, देख लीजिए 5-7-8 डेफिनेशंस देख लीजिए, उसके बाद कम अप विथ योर ओन डेफिनेशन, दैट विल बी यूनिक, राइट. So can anyone tell me what is a memo? In the first class, I discussed about a memo is something, a short note, which is the Latin phrase memoranda. It has been taken from a Latin phrase, which means to?
Remind.
To remind.
To remind. To remember.
Yeah, what's that? Yes.
Memo is short note or that immediate information or that for people to hear that new policy.
ठीक है, try to speak English. ग्रुप को भी दिया जाता है और इंडिविजुअली भी दिया जाता है. इट कैन आल्सो बी गिवन इंडिविजुअली. यू आर अ मैनेजर, यू वांट टू इश्यू अ मेमो टू समबडी हु इज नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ मेमो दैट विल बी? डिसिप्लिनरी वार्निंग. Let us start with the definition and then the introduction. The word memorandum has been taken from the Latin word memorare. Memorare, which means to remember. Memorare. These little bit of information is important for MCQs. So, taken from a Latin word, Latin phrase, memorare, which means to remember. Memorare, remember. Do not forget. Keep in mind. In law, a memorandum means a document recording terms of contract. For VBA students, these things are very important because you will be needing this when you start working. The plural form is memoranda. Do not write memorandums. That is not used now. Plural mein kya hota hai? Memoranda. Singular, memorandum. Short form, memo. So it is commonly used, better known as a memo. So what is the introduction? What are the points? First of all, it is a Latin word which means to remember. Secondly, in law, it means it's a record of a contract. Thirdly, the plural is memoranda. And fourthly, the short form of memorandum is memo. Point wise, aap yaad rakhenge, theek hai? Aapko exam mein, it will be easy for you. Write down the points. The advantages of memos. Cost effective, but inexpensive. It doesn't cost a lot. You do not need the best quality paper. You do not have to send this outside the organization. So you have to give it to anybody in the in-house. So it is inexpensive. Costly nahi hota hai. Sabse pehli baat hai, it is quick and convenient. It is inexpensive. The advantages can be 5 marks, can be 10 marks. Such questions carry 4 marks in your external exam. And it is a written record. The biggest advantage is that it is a record which is kept, documented. So nobody can erase that. So continuing with the advantages, a memo should be designed to get your message across quickly. It should be designed in such a way, formatted in such a way, so that your message reaches the audience or the targeted person quickly. In other words, we would like to say that memos should not be too long, because nobody has the time today to read your long, lengthy messages. Busy people do not want to waste time reading unnecessary information. So do not put in anything which is not relevant. Unnecessary information should be avoided. Write only what is important. It should be direct and to the point. The language of memo should be conversational. The way you speak, similarly you write. Do not write down the entire content. Just write down a few words. Ravi Raj is busy writing the line by line, line word for word, line by line. Huh?
No, ma'am.
The second question, the purpose of a memo. Why do we write a memo at all? We write a memo to inquire, to ask, if you want to ask something, you write a memo. For example, a manager marketing can write to the manager HR to inquire about something, isn't it? To inform, to report, to remind, and to promote goodwill. What is the meaning of to promote goodwill? Goodwill ka matlab kya hota hai?
Assets
for creating a good impression.
Reputation
of the company.
Value.
How will you create, Ravi Raj, how will you create a goodwill when you start working in any organization? How will you create goodwill? अभी सोचने में लग गया क्या करेंगे हम ऐसा कुछ क्या करेंगे जो कि गुडविल बने इज्जत बरकरार रहे ऐसा कुछ नहीं करते गुडविल तो खत्म हो जाए एनीवेज
बेहतर करेंगे बेटर
प्रोडक्ट ओके द पर्पस ऑफ द मेमो इज टू इंक्वायर इन ऑफिसेस. In any office, there are a lot of things you do not know and you want to know. It is best to ask than to keep quiet. आप कुछ नहीं जानते तो क्या बैठे रहेंगे जब तक कोई आके कोई बताएगा नहीं मैं कुछ काम नहीं करूंगा मैं बैठा हूं. Will you get up and ask? Verbally or in a memo? In a memo. So the purpose of memo writing, to inquire when we want to gather information which is required. Nahin. Notice board pe lagta hai. Notice internal bhi hota hai, notice bahar se bhi aata hai, bank se bhi notice aata hai. Nahin aata hai. तो जिस कोर्ट से भी आता है. Anybody can send you a notice. मेरा घर खाली करो. मेमो इज क्वाइट डिफरेंट. उसको मिलाना नहीं है. मेमो मेमो है, नोटिस नोटिस है. टू इन्फॉर्म, टू रिपोर्ट, टू रिमाइंड. द पर्पस इज टू रिमाइंड somebody of a, टू कॉल टू एक्शन. किसी को कोई काम करना है. टू रिमाइंड समवन. सो सपोजिंग एक्स वाई जेड टीचर इज एब्सेंट. The teacher will give a memo horizontally that please, I will be absent on such and such date, attend my class. Right? So it will be something to remind, to promote goodwill, to warn, or likhe, to warn. By warning, you have done something which you should not have done. So, the higher authority is warning you. For example, you're coming late, you're not doing your work properly, or you are taking too much leave, or that a lot of work is pending. So the HR will not be happy with you. So under any concern, if the HR is not happy with you, the person can serve a memo to you. What are the characteristics of an effective memo? एक effective memo लिखने के लिए क्या क्या चीजें, क्या कौन कौन सी बातें जरूरी हैं? What are the things which are सबसे पहले तो दिमाग में आना चाहिए the seven C's of communication. Any written document, the first thing which should flash in your mind is the seven C's of communication.
Clarity.
सबसे पहले तुम जो मेमो देना चाह रहे हो सोचो कि क्लियर है कि नहीं. या किसी को आप मेमो दे रहे हैं और नहीं भी दे रहे हैं, मतलब कि दिया भी और नहीं भी दिया, मतलब दिया लेकिन क्लियर नहीं था, बंदे को समझ ही नहीं आया कि वार्निंग है या प्रेज है, ये क्या है, ये are you happy or are you must tell the person why you are issuing a memo. For example, take an example of a person who is taking too much leave. Bahut zyada leave leta hai. Any employee who takes a lot of leave, you as a manager, HR, will be issuing a memo to him. तो सबसे पहले क्लियरली स्टेट कीजिएगा ना कि उसको सीधे वार्निंग दे दीजिएगा, यू विल बी फायर्ड फ्रॉम द जॉब. ऐसा लिखेंगे क्या? नहीं, इसलिए कि कर्टसी पे नहीं आता है. दे आर नॉट योर स्लेव्स, दे आर योर एम्प्लॉइज. सो इस बात को मद्देनजर रखते हुए कि वो आपके गुलाम नहीं है, वो आपके यहाँ काम कर रहे हैं. उसकी कुछ वजह होगी लेट, बीमारी की वजह से, व्हाटएवर द रीजन इज. सो यू हैव टू शो म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट. So you must tell the person why you are issuing a memo. सबसे पहले काम क्या आता है, सब्जेक्ट लाइन क्लियर कर देता है कि क्यों मेमो लिख रहे हैं. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर इशूंग अ मेमो फॉर समबडी हूज टेकिंग टू मच लीव, व्हाट विल बी द सब्जेक्ट लाइन? कंसर्न रिगार्डिंग टू मच ऑफ लीव टेकिंग. The person will be, once the person sees the subject line, he will know the memo is for this. और सबसे पहले तो memo ऊपर लिखा जाता है, ये memo है. Subject देके समझ में आता है कि this is the memo for warning. So how will you start this memo? अभी आपको वही लिखवाने वाले थे. It has been observed, ऐसा देखा गया है कि we regret to say that. मतलब मुझे, हम लोगों को खेद है ये लिखते हुए. वी रिग्रेट टू से दैट एज इट हैज बीन ऑब्जर्व दैट यू हैव बीन टेकिंग टू मच ऑफ लीव. you are directed to. Give reasons for your taking leave. Plus, आपको और भी लिखना होगा, so that in future the company, the work gets hampered. मतलब काम for the smooth running of any organization, it is necessary that all of us should take the sanctioned leave. As too much of leave taking can prove disastrous for the company. Hope this kindly resolve this issue at your from your end. अपनी तरफ से इसको आप देख लीजिए. Right? So anything which you write, any memo which you write, the characteristics should carry the all the 7 C's of communication. सबसे पहली बात तो ये clarity. Tell the person why the memo is being issued. Concise. Do not write long, lengthy, narrative, descriptive. जरूरत ही नहीं है. Unity of theme. मतलब एक ही टॉपिक पे रही है. We are talking about late coming. Talk about only late coming. We are talking about too much leave. Talk about only leave. If you have to issue 10 memos to a person, if they are 10 concerns, आप 10 memo issue कर दीजिए. लेकिन एक थीम पे रहिए आप. And your tone should be informal. This is how it is, why it is different from a letter. Letter में formal tone होता है ना, memo में informal tone होता है. मैंने पहले ही कहा था, you will write a memo the way you are speaking, conversational style. A little informal because ये घर की बात है ना, अंदर की बात है, बाहर थोड़ी चिट्ठी लिख रहे हैं, लेटर थोड़ी लिख रहे हैं. अब ये घर की ही बात है, within the organization. Be a little informal. अगर बिल्कुल formal touch उसमें भी डालेंगे, then you will miss out the essence of the HR feels that the connectivity, interpersonal communication flies off. अगर आप बहुत ज्यादा formal हो जाते हैं तो इंटरपर्सनल कम्युनिकेशन थोड़ा सा हैम्पर्ड हो जाता है. दैट इज व्हाई मेमोज आई इश्यूड विद अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ इनफॉर्मल टोन, बिकॉज इट हैज टू बी कनेक्टेड. इंटरपर्सनल कम्युनिकेशन शुड बी देयर. अंडरस्टूड? नाउ टेल मी व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अ मेमो. सबसे पहले तो 7 C's ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन सामने है आपके. क्या क्या है बताइए. ये सब एक चीज सिखा दिया गया ना, वो लाइफ लॉन्ग चलता रहेगा. वो हर तरह से वाई, जैसे मैंने दिया था आपको क्वेश्चन, कम्युनिकेशन इज द ब्लड लाइन और लाइफ लाइन फॉर एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. कुछ नहीं करना था उसमें. विदाउट कम्युनिकेशन यू कैन नॉट रन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एंड इन कम्युनिकेशन इफ यू आर नॉट क्लियर एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल फेल. तो वो ऐसा चीज मंत्र है, 7 C's ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन दैट फिट्स. हर जगह आप उसको यूज कर सकते हैं. आप कोई उसको आपको नो नहीं कर सकता उसको. राइट. अब ये नहीं कि हर आंसर में वही रहेगा. You already know hundreds and hundreds of times we have talked about clarity. A memo must be clearly written because an unclear and vague memo will confuse the reader, leading to delay and no action. So, क्या क्या clarity से क्या क्या problem होता है? Unnecessary delay, unnecessary confusion, and no action. Confused हो जाएगा बंदा. Delay, leading to delay, and the very purpose, action नहीं होगा. That is why एक ही बार लिखो, बार बार लिखने की जरूरत नहीं पड़े. there should not be any question in the person's mind. All the questions should be answered in the memo. Whatever you want, this is it. So a vague message, क्या क्या कर सकता है? Delay और क्लास में हो भी कि नहीं, तुम हो ना, तो इंटरैक्ट कर, पूछते हैं तो जवाब दिया करो.
मैम इसको वैग्यू मेमो की वैग्यू क्या?
वेग 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 मतलब क्या होता है? व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वेग? समथिंग व्हिच इज नॉट क्लियर.
अनक्लियर लाइक
लाइक व्हेन यू आर वेयरिंग अ मास्क एंड यू आर स्पीकिंग एवरीथिंग बिकम्स वेग राइट. थिंग्स बिकम वेग. कई लोग इसको वेग्यू बोल देते हैं, लेकिन अभी भी समझिए इसको VAGUE वेग मतलब कि नॉट क्लियर. I'll take another 10 minutes because, as it is Nitish sir is has not come today.
Absolutely.
Conciseness मतलब to the point होना चाहिए. It should not be too long. Concise and direct memos are often effective. सबसे बड़ी बात है कि effectiveness के लिए conciseness important है. And direct. Say whatever you want to say directly. A memo should contain only essential information. Unimportant information मत डालिए. Avoid unnecessary explanation, repetitions, wordy expressions and amplification. It means anything which is not supposed to be written, don't write. Don't amplify. Do not magnify. बहुत बड़ा करके issue बना के नहीं करना है. जैसे कोई कोई अगर late आ रहा है या कोई बहुत ज्यादा leave ले रहा है, उसको मत कहिए कि ये काम आपका नहीं हुआ, वो काम आपका नहीं हुआ, फलाने सर ने ये कहा, फलाने ने ये कहा. Not necessary. Ensure that you use less word. The red में जो लिखा हुआ है उसको आप लिख लीजिए. Ensure that the memo makes its point with the fast, with the fewest, makes it fastest with fewest words. सबसे quick पहुंचता है कम शब्दों में, fast and few. किसी को नींद आ रही? They are really dumb, I tell you. What happened? All right, that's it for today. We'll continue this in the next class.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much.